It's Vanessa with Farmgirl Gardens and Market, and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, I am a permaculture designer and edible garden coach in North Central Texas, and I am taking you along with me on our farm project as we sustainably recover this land that had been overgrazed and eroded due to watershed for quite some time. Our purpose here is to grow as much food as we can for our tables and the tables of those in need, and to equip our community to do the same by creating these garden demonstrations so that I can teach and equip garden leaders to do the same. So now that you know a little bit more about me, gosh, it's early morning, I'm sorry y'all, why I'm here and what I'm doing, let's talk about aphids, right? So it is July, y'all, it is hot, and if you haven't had aphid damage yet, we are now starting to just see it all over the garden. Aphids are tiny little sucking insects that are coming to your plant because they are using the sugar that the plant is making for its own energy through the process of photosynthesis. And they are stealing that sugar out of the fruit by sucking on leaves and the actual fruit that sets. One of the problems with aphids is they are so tiny that it can be difficult to see them. So I want to show you on this cucumber plant that, you know, if you were just to quickly walk through the garden, this plant looks beautiful and gorgeous. And since this is an organically sustained garden, we try not to do a lot of interventions. We try to observe and see if nature can handle it and welcome the beneficial things into the grow space that will also support it. An example for aphids is when I first noticed aphids were here, I was observing to see when the ladybugs would arrive. And sure enough, ladybugs are the number one defender of aphids in the garden. And they did, but there just wasn't enough of them. So I want to show you now what I recommend when you are mid-season, it's hot, it's humid, you've done everything organically or DIY that you can, and now we need to do something a little bit more. So let me just show you so we know what we're talking about first. If you can see on this cucumber plant, it's doing great. One of the things that I was confused by, though, that started my questioning of what's going on with this plant is that lots of fruit set, but very little fruit development. And so if you're seeing that, it can be at this point in summer because it's just too hot and the flowers will fall. But if your plant is being attacked, the first thing that you will notice is that a decline in fruit setting. So up here, I want to show you aphids typically affect the underside of the leaves. That's where they live. But you can even see some of their damage because of the way that this cucumber is trellised, how it falls on the top of the leaves. But on the underside is really where we're trying to find them. Okay, and do you see, it's a little hard to tell, but right there, do you see those little yellow specks? This would be what I would consider like an early aphid infestation. But when you get down to the bottom where there's more humidity issues and there's a lot of tight clumping of leaves, that's where it's really gotten aggressive, and you can actually see the discoloration on the leaves and all of the aphids on the underside there. And so, okay, now we know what they are, where they are, and what they're doing. How do we get rid of them? So early infestations, absolutely, you can shoot the underside of the leaves with a hard spray of water, and just the water spray alone, the strength of that will crush their tiny little bodies. But if you have tried that and it hasn't worked and you're still, you know, looking at a plant that's looking like this, we need to do something more. And so for me, what that looks like in an organically sustained garden is I first recommend that you do an insecticidal soap. I typically use Dr. Bronner's, about 2 tablespoons to 1 gallon of water. You can play around with it, or you can find, plenty of recipes on Google, but that's just mine. But since I believe that if you're going to go ahead and treat, you may as well make it worth your while, I do more than just the insecticidal soap. I add 1 tablespoon of neem oil to my insecticidal soaps when I am treating aphids. Neem oil is from the neem tree, which actually is from New Zealand, and it is a highly aromatic compound. Lots of methyl groups in that benzene ring, which makes it have such a strong fragrance. And the result of that is that it is a very minty or methyl smell. But it also can be quite denaturing to these little tiny bodies of the aphids. So the neem oil is a great addition to your organically sustained garden. A caveat to the application is because it is an oil, you need to be careful that when you're applying it, especially in Texas in full sun, that you're not doing it on a bright, sunny day, because that oil will sit on the surface of leaves and fry your plant. You do, when you're treating aphids, want to make sure that you're directing that oil to the underside of the leaves, but you still want to apply that on an undercast day because UV light will find you anywhere. Another thing that I wanted to talk about is when you have a decision to make about, do I pull this plant and retry, or do I try and support it? And generally, I say try and support it if we're looking like this. If it's just the aphids alone, but you're still seeing flowers, the plant is still trying to survive, go ahead and support it. But if it's looking like there's no flowers, it's dead on the vine, it's really just struggling, then that's an instance where I would say go ahead and pull it, because you're going to potentially invite more risks and pests into your space than if you were to just take that plant out. Another thing that you can do in Texas for your cucumbers and your squash that tend to get affected by the same pests this time of year is to continue to succession plant them. Believe it or not, they actually love the heat. So even though they struggle with a lot of humidity and pest-related issues because of the heat, they do well in it. You can direct sow right now. Now's the time, so go ahead and keep getting those in, because especially the petite varieties, the later that you get in season, you want to start looking at your seed packet to see the length of maturity. Start sowing the shorter cucumbers, right? Like the five inchers, the gherkins. You want the tinier ones because they're going to come into maturity faster at this point in the season. That's all that I have to say about aphids, neem oil, and succession planting. And I hope that it was helpful and that you're well. And until next time, y'all. Bye.